Hi everybody, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot and welcome to your weekly tarot forecast. Before I get started with the reading, I just want to take a second and thank all of my subscribers. Thank you guys so very much for all of your likes, your shares, and your comments. Thank you to my new subscribers and thank you to all of my subscribers that have been with me. Thank you so very much. If you are looking for additional guidance aside from the weekly and monthly tarot forecast that I offer here on my channel, please head over to Facebook or Instagram and follow me there because I do actually draw and upload a daily oracle guidance card every single day. And if you are interested in receiving a private reading from me, please head over to northeasttarot.com. I do have it linked below in the description bar and read about how I offer my private readings. Right now, for a limited time only, I am offering 2017 yearly readings. So if you're interested in receiving a 2017 yearly reading, please head over there and book yours now. And for these general tarot forecasts, please be sure to watch your sun, moon, and rising signs for the most insight. If you do not know what your moon or rising sign are, I do have also linked below in the description bar a website that can calculate that for you for free. So please head over there and enter your information so you can get the most insight into these weekly or monthly tarot forecasts that I offer here. And if you do not subscribe to my channel, please do, because I do upload every week. And also every month as well. So I do wish you guys just a wonderful week. Stay tuned for the reading. Hi Aries, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot and welcome to your weekly tarot forecast for the week of December 5th through the 11th. This is for Aries Sun, Aries Moon, and Aries Rising signs. All right, Aries, so at the bottom of the deck, I have the Knight of Cups. Okay, so for some Aries, there could be a Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces person that's very significant this week. But some of you actually could be receiving an offer with the Knight of Cups. This could be an offer of love that's coming through, or just an offer that, you know, makes your heart race. It's very exciting. So for some Aries, you could be receiving an offer. For other Aries, this could be your energy. You could be extending an offer to someone. The overall energy, Aries, for the week is the Page of Wands, which is communication. So for some Aries, you definitely could be receiving that offer, that communication. In regards to walking down a new path, the Page of Wands for some of you is you, you know, going on a new adventure. This is you walking down a new path in life, and it's very, very exciting. It could be something that you're very passionate about. And then for other Aries, you know, this is maybe that communication coming through. Often with the Page of Wands, it's communication that you were expecting or communication that you had to wait on for a little bit. But with the Knight of Cups here and the Page of Wands, I definitely see many of you receiving that really exciting communication or news. For some of you, it's an offer. It's an offer that maybe allows you to walk down a new path. It could be, you know, for some Aries, this could be you landing a new job. Or this could be you starting a new relationship. We are starting out with the Hermit. So for some Aries, maybe you have to spend some time alone. You have to go within. The Hermit can represent you seeking that solitude. Really spending some time alone, maybe in the beginning of the week, going within, listening to your intuition when it comes to, should you maybe walk down this new path or should you accept this offer for some of you? The Hermit can also represent an attorney, or this can be an older gentleman that could be very significant. This could be a Virgo. For some of you, maybe you're seeking some guidance or some advice from maybe a father or even a grandfather, or this could definitely be an attorney for some Aries, because I have the Hermit and then I also have the Queen of Swords here. So there could be an attorney that you're speaking with this week, an attorney that's contacting you, or maybe you're contacting them. But also with the Queen of Swords, this could be an Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra person that's quite significant. Maybe you're receiving enlightenment from this person. The Queen of Swords for me represents someone who is a truth seeker, someone who wants to cut to the truth of the matter, or get down to the bottom of things. So for some of you, you're receiving maybe this communication or this clarity, this enlightenment that maybe you've been waiting on that really allows for things to move forward. I do have the Page of Pentacles here, so this could definitely be in regards to a new job or something to do with finances or maybe even something legal. So this could be that financial offer or opportunity that's coming through, or communication in regards to finances that's coming through, that clarity that really allows for things to move forward. I have the Six of Swords here. So for some of you, you're definitely maybe traveling, or there's some sort of movement that's very significant. And then for others, maybe now you're able to mentally move forward, move towards that peace of mind, because maybe you're becoming enlightened, or you're hearing from your attorney or this ear sign person. With the Six of Swords, this is you moving from stormy waters to much more calmer waters, moving towards peace of mind. And it's because you're now enlightened, or you've received some clarity in regards to a particular matter. Also, for some of you, this could very well be your energy. You could be spending more time alone this week. Also, with the Queen of Swords, you're in your mind, you're planning for the future, you're strategizing. This is that very logical energy here. So for some of you, this could definitely be your energy as well. You know, using this sword to sever ties from, you know, people, situations, whatever it is that's no longer serving you. This is more of a serious energy. And I see many of you very focused on moving forward. Now, the Six of Swords is moving towards, yes, the Page of Wands here, but also justice. So moving down a new path, moving towards peace of mind, definitely moving towards some healing. But also justice, maybe things being made fair. This could also be that karmic justice, moving towards bringing more balance into your life in some way. Justice can also represent, maybe this is a legal matter for some of you. This could be you moving towards that legal decision, or that legal decision could be the communication that is coming through this week that really allows for you to move on with your life. But for others, this can also be that contract. So if, you know, for some of you, maybe this communication or this opportunity is in regards to a new job, and this could be you signing a contract this week, Aries. Whatever this is something that I feel like you want greatly. You're emotionally attached to this in some way with the Seven of Wands here. For some Aries, you certainly might have had to fight for this. With the Seven of Wands, this is what I call that warrior spirit energy. So maybe some of you having to defend what it is that you think is right, or what it is that you think you deserve. Standing firm with what it is that you want, not backing down, not compromising. Really being quite strong, very passionate, and having a lot of strength and courage. Because there's something I believe you're emotionally invested in with the Four of Cups, this could have been you waiting on an offer or waiting on something, information to come through, feeling very bored or discontent with having to wait. But I see many of you receiving that justice. We have the Six of Pentacles underneath the Justice card, which is very generous energy. It represents either giving or receiving. And I think that some of you could be receiving that legal decision, or receiving that decision that maybe you've been waiting on, maybe in regards to a new home or assets, something financial, something that I feel like you're emotionally attached to, but it's also something that's very exciting. So for some of you, it's maybe that decision. For others, this could have something to do with a contract. But we see you receiving this decision or this contract. For some of you, that fairness, things being made right. Maybe you had to fight for this. This, again, could be something legal. But overall, as you can see, it's going to be an amazing week for you. I see many of you becoming enlightened. You're now moving towards peace of mind. This is you moving down a new path. With the Page of Wands, it's something that's very exciting. It's like a new adventure here. Let me pull you an additional guidance card. So overall, Aries, this is a great spread. With justice, this is a yes answer. So justice is going to be served. Communication is going to be very significant this week. Financially, I think it's going to be a great week. I definitely see many Aries moving towards things balancing out, more balance coming in. For some of you, that definitely will be, you know, in regards to finances, things balancing out financially for you. Let me pull you an additional guidance card, Aries, for the upcoming week. Some additional guidance. Yeah, I definitely see some of you receiving an offer. You very well might need to spend some time alone to think about this offer. And then for other Aries, you might need to, maybe you have to speak to a father or a grandfather. Maybe you just seek some advice from someone in regards to this. Let's see, we have two cards that came out. Wow. All right, so we have Ray. Yoga and exercise are essential to your well-being, peace of mind, and spiritual growth right now. So for some of you, I'm definitely seeing you spending some time alone, maybe meditating. For others, this necessarily doesn't mean you have to do some yoga. This is just spirit focusing on your health. And also you bringing in that peace of mind, which I definitely see many of you doing. But maybe spending some time alone, meditating, or even maybe doing some yoga or exercising could be something that benefits you greatly. And then we also have Fiona. Now that you've asked the angels for help, be open to receiving divine guidance and assistance. You deserve heaven's help. Beautiful. So for many of you, you're definitely receiving that divine guidance, that assistance, but you have to be open. So this is for some of you, you needing to surrender, you needing to go with the flow, and just remaining open and positive to receiving that help, okay? So overall, Aries, you have some great energies to work with. I do hope that you found this reading helpful, and I wish you a great week. Take care.